Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Electronic 80s. My name's Ian McLuckie. Let's start in 1989. A number one for Madonna, Like a Prayer.
Thank you.
And number one for Madonna from 1989, Like a Prayer. Let's stay in 1989 now and Liza Minnelli, who collaborated with the Pet Shop Boys and come up with a Stephen Sondheim song from Follies from 1970s, Losing My Mind. Liza Minnelli in collaboration with the Pet Shop Boys. I'm sure you noticed that was the Pet Shop Boys. It sounds very, very Pet Shop Boysy. Let's go back to 1985. And if you remember, a TV series called Hospital Watch. It starred Frank Boff, Debbie Thrower, the Breakfast Time team. And it used to be on at 8 o'clock in the evenings. So I think it was a Thursday evening after Top of the Pops. And this was the theme tune from it. It actually was a single, and it's been a single for many other things, and you'll probably just about remember it. A bit of classics on electronic 80s, La Serenissima, Rondo Veneziano. From an album, Venison Pearl, from 1981, but that was actually the 1985. It came out and it actually managed to get to number 58 in the charts.
I want to ride. I was a little girl, I had a rag doll.
Yeah.
from 1988, Erasure. That was the B-side of Ship of Fools, which made number six. That's not often you hear that, is it? And before that, did you spot my deliberate mistake? Yes, it was from 1991. Haha, I caught you all out there. And the Pet Shop Boys, where the streets have no name and can't take your my eyes off you. Their versions. From 1986, The Communards and Don't Leave Me This Way, also featuring Sarah J. Morris, who is a very accomplished jazz singer. Let's move on a year to 1987, and Donna Summer came back with some new material. She had been around playing some, well, with some of the new covers from the late 70s and moved into the 80s, but this was some new stuff. And off the album, All Systems Go, is Dinner with Gershwin. Reached number 13, Donna Summer and Dinner with Gershwin. It was written by Brenda Russell of Piano in the Dark fame.
Yeah.
And Everything She Wants. That got to number two. Why do you not remember it? Well, you probably do remember it in 1984. Christmas time in 1984. It was a double A single. It had Last Christmas was on one side and Everything She Wants was in the other.
Thank you.
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, that was a hit in 1970s, wasn't it? I'm saying, yeah, you're right, it was. It was a hit in 1979, when it managed to reach number 17. It also was a hit in 1993, when it managed number 16. But in 1984, therefore I can do it, it reached number 4. Sister Sledge, Lost in Music.
Thank you.
Can you believe that was Mick Jagger's solo single, his first one he done, from 1985, from the She's the Boss album, Just Another Night, managed to get into the top 20, and that was about it.
Don't worry, I won't hurt you. I only want you to have some fun.
Take your pick from 1982, Prince 1999, or from 1985, Prince 1999. Either way, it was still in the 80s. That's it. Time up for me today. I've thoroughly enjoyed myself. I hope you have too. I'll catch you next time. Until the next time anyway, my name's Ian McLuckie, and I'll leave you with, from 1989, Kirsty MacColl and Don't Come the Cowboy.
Just go back on the socks that had stayed on. The next time they see you, they treat you like dirt. The next time they treat you like dirt. Now don't come the cowboy with me, Sonny Jim. I know lots of those and you're not one of them. There's a light in your eyes tells me somebody's in and you won't come the cowboy with me. Smile and say cheese, they're so eager to please, but they'll never remember your name. The names and the places all change. But don't come the cowboy with me, Sonny Jim. I know lots of those and you're not one of them. There's a light in your eyes tells me somebody's in and you won't come.
Radio Lewes. Local. Community webcasting.